so full of nectar.
Yes.
Bhattaji Maharaj is moving over so much material without examining deeply, because I asked him to give you the overview. So that means in your spare time you have to do your homework. He's giving you the shape, the current of the feeling, why Bhagavatam is unfolding in a particular sequence. He's sharing many ideas which are only in the dhvani, not in the words, but in the implications. And also many things even which are not in the commentaries, but which are coming in the Srota Parampara by hearing in a direct, unbroken line from Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, because Bhattaji Maharaj's ancestor was the first and main disciple of Raghunath Bhatta Goswami. So 500 years ago, even Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, they used to listen to Bhagavatam from Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, and what they were listening then, you are hearing today. So you are very, very lucky. So this Katha has come down in the family for 500 years. But Bhattaji Maharaj has no son to continue the tradition. So I am making application that he will adopt me. Then you can go on. So are there some questions from the morning time? Oh, Rasik is not here. Oh, here he is. I was just saying, Rasik is not here with his questions. Yes, who had the question? Sunil Gopal. Yes.
What is
Vaibhava Prakash and Vaibhava
Vilas? If Sri Krishna expands, and the expansion, the complexion is somewhat different, and the mood is somewhat different, it's called Vaibhava Prakash.
Если, предположим, есть какая-то экспансия Кришны, которая немного отличается, в форме своего настроения, то это называется Вайбава Пракаш.
But the form is the same.
А форма та же самая?
Yeah. Complexion is different, mood is different, but form is same.
А форма та же самая?
For example, Balaram is Krishna's Vaibhava Prakash. Because he looks like Krishna, but his complexion is fair and his mood is different. Vasudev Krishna in Gorkha is Vaibhava Prakash of Krishna. Even though his complexion is same, but his mood is different. But if that Dwarkadish Krishna will sometimes manifest four arms, then it will be Vaibhava Vilas, Vilas Vigraha, because the form is not the same. Then, if the Krishna or any expansion of Krishna will manifest many forms at the same time, which are the same as the form from which they have come, it will be called the Prabhav Prakash.
Ну, например, если Кришна создаст много форм, которые не отличны от той формы, оригинальной формы, которую он создает, это называется Prabhav Prakash.
So if Krishna will manifest many forms to dance with gopis, but all look the same, that is called Prabhav Prakash, not Vaibhav, because Vaibhav means V. Some speciality, some vishesh, something is different. Whereas Prabhav just means influence.
Вайбхав означает ги, какая-то особенность, что-то особенное. А прабхав – это, ну, то же самое. В общем, когда, например, Кришна создает много форм, сколько на рассадили, то вот это называется прабхав
Пракаш. So the Prakash manifestations are two-armed, and the Vilas manifestations are not either four-armed or eight-armed or not even human. Different forms.
Prakash это когда та же самая форма, а Vilas это когда может быть четыре руки, восемь руки, даже восемь.
So they're called Vilas Vigraha.
Тогда это называется Vilas Vigraha.
No. It depends on the qualification of the person. You see, before Kumaras, at that point, they were Jnanis, they were not Bhaktas, so there was no possibility that they could go to Paravyom Vaikuntha. When Durvasa Rishi was being chased by the Chakra, he was also actually a devotee, but he was doing Leela like a yogi. So he could only go to the Ramakriya Vaikuntha. So, before Kumaras went to Ramapriya Vaikuntha, only because of the mercy of their father Brahma, who was praying for them. So, when Vaishnav prays for us, and we can get.
Четверо кумаров попали на Рама Прия Вайкунту только по милости их отца Брама, который молился за них. То есть только по милости Вайшнава мы можем вот так куда-то попасть.
So by the mercy of Brahma, they were allowed to go to that Рама Прия Вайкунта, which is within the Брахманда.
Это Рама Прия Вайкунта находится внутри Брахманды.
Dhruva Maharaj also went to Рама Прия Вайкунта because at the time of his sadhana he had worldly desires, though he gave them up. So he would go to Vaikuntha, but because his bhakti was, the sadhan did not fit in the category of Anya Blasta Shunyam, he could not go outside of the coverings of the Brahmanda.
Dhruva Maharaj тоже попал на Вайкунту, Рамакрия Вайкунту, которая находится внутри Брахманды, он не смог выйти за ее пределы, потому что когда он совершал садхану, у него не было Анья Блашта Шуньям, то есть у него были немного другие тогда желания.
I was wondering if you could give us a little bit of like Shastra first aid, because it's my first time hearing Shastra really, well, not really my first time, but I haven't had much contact with the scriptures. And
so you can see in Braja that it's perfectly normal for a person to know the complete Srimad Bhagavatam and many other shastras. Here in Braja, there are very high level pandits like our Shastri Ji who came. Even the boy that was with him was also very learned. So those who carry the Srimad Bhagavatam always in their heart, they are called Bhagavata. So by hearing from them and serving them, you should also become a Bhagavata. So you should begin by learning the Dasamula Shikshan of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Don't put anything in your mouth. In Vedic culture, it is said that you have one tube. It starts here and comes out the other end. And both ends, they have the same amount of cleanliness. So never put anything in the mouth, not a finger, not a pencil, nothing. If you touch anything, you have to wash hands afterwards. Okay, so first learn Dasamo Shiksha. This is not an ancient text. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has presented this, but in one verse, it shows you the 10 fundamental teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Шрила Бхактивинода Тхакур в своей Дасамо Шикше объясняет все фундаментальные учения Шикшатани.
So mool means root.
Mool означает.
So on the basis of this root, the tree can grow into many many branches.
И на основе этого корня, на котором действительно все дерево, тогда оно может разрастись различными ветвями.
So after learning the Dasamo Shiksha, 10 basic teachings of Mahaprabhu, then you should learn the pramans, the evidence for each one of those teachings. From the Shastra which is accepted by everyone, Bhagavad Gita.
То есть когда вы уже выучите Дасму Шикшу, без изучения Шикшатани Махапрабху, вы можете переходить к тому, чтобы изучать Праманы. И к этим учениям они даны Бхагавад Гита.
So, there's one book called Shlokamrita, and it's all the main verses my Gurudev used to use in preaching. You can get this book and go through it step by step and memorize.
Есть одна книга, которая называется «Шлокамрита» Парам Гурудева, где написаны все шлоки, очень важные, и можете
лучше All my Gurudev's books you can buy in Lloyd Bazaar, otherwise you can download them for free. My Gurudev said, no copyright on my books, copy left. That means you can, they're free online, and if anyone else wants to print them and distribute them, anyone can do it, as long as they don't change anything, that's all.
Парам Гурудев говорит, что нет на моих книгах никакого копирайта, то есть вы можете бесплатно их скачать, вы можете, конечно, купить на Lloyd Bazaar, но все можно бесплатно скачать, и любой человек при условии того, что они будут ничего менять, может это бесплатно не скачать.
So my Gurudev was showing, don't have a business model, have a mercy model.
Таким образом, мой Гурудев говорит, что вам не нужна бизнес-модель, вам нужна модель милости.
Make the model how everyone can get the mercy. And then more mercy will come to you. Don't worry about it. So start with this. When you've learned every shloka in that book, you'll know. That's somebody. The Shukadev Goswami, there are two parts of the question. What should someone do who will die right now? And what should someone do if you will die after some time? So Shukadev Goswami answered, if you die right now, then Etanya Vajamananam, Ichatam Kutobayam, Yoginam Rapaninitam, Harinam Anukirtanam. If you're going to die right now, just do Kirtan continuation. Yes. And if you die after some time, then you should hear Harikatha. Because by hearing Harikatha, you will develop a particular sambandha, relationship with Krishna. Then when you chant the holy name with that sambandha, then instead of just getting liberation from the holy name or going to Vaikuntha, you can be related to Krishna and go to Goloka Vrindavan.
Есть две тонкости по поводу Харикатхи, когда Махарадж Парикшит задал вопрос Шукадева Госвами. Можно спросить, что делать, если я умру прямо сейчас, а можно спросить, что делать, если я умру через некоторое время. Так вот, если вы знаете, что вы умрете прямо сейчас, то просто совершайте кирпан, воспевайте святые имена. Если у вас есть в запасе какое-то время, то слушайте Харикатху, потому что тогда она даст вам самбанду, ваше знание о определенных отношениях с Кришной, и тогда у вас будет возможность... И совершайте кирпан в этом настроении. Тогда у вас будет возможность развить с Кришной более возвышенную самбанду, нежели просто попасть на
Вайкунтху. So, by Диксха Мантра, especially Gopal Mantra, Gurudev awakens the one samband, the relation with Krishna, and through Harikatha he nourishes that relationship.
Через Диксха Мантра, особенно Gopal Mantra, Gurudev дает вашу самбанду с Кришной. И в дальнейшем через Харикатху он углубляет.
Then one should chant Japa from the perspective of that relationship.
И мы должны воспевать джапу на основе этого отношения.
So don't remember Gayatri mantras and then forget everything and then chant Hare Krishna like it's two different things. Remember Gayatri mantra to become fixed in your relationship, then chant Hare Krishna in that relationship.
То есть не воспринимайте ваше комментирование гайд и воспринимание джавы как две отдельные вещи. Нет, вы читаете гайд, комментируете гайд в определенном настроении, с арбандой, и в таком же настроении воспринимаете джаву.
Gachibanchu is like a pot, and Harinam is like the rice. The pot is there to cook the rice, to make it very soft and fragrant, delicious and nourishing.
Gachibanchu
is like a pot, and Harinam is like the rice. Who is this Prabhu?
Satkirtan.
Satkirti. Satkirti. Where are you from?
From Riga.
From Riga. I visited there recently.
I visited the last lecture. How can I say from Riga?
Okay, last question for today.
Is asking about the class of the Sharup Shloka. The third, Maharaj said that the third Shloka is about Prem. But he says if you have to look at the Shloka, you cannot really directly see that it's about Prem. Can you please explain this?
If you see the messages that Krishna sent to the gopis through Buddha, or if you look at what Krishna said to gopis at Kurukshetra, it's saying yata mahanti bhutani bhuteshu cha vateshnu pravastana pravastani tatateshu nateshvaham. So when gopis first heard it, they reacted in that way. What is this? Talking about elements and creation. The elements are inside everything and also remain outside everything. Remember, he said in the creation, then Mahavishnu looks towards Prakriti and all the elements come. And then he takes a portion of that and makes the universe. So some element is in the universe and some elements outside. So then gopis are thinking, why is Krishna saying this? This is, we love him, we came to see him, and he should say something romantic. Why is he saying this stuff?
Gopis also think, why is Krishna saying this? This is, we love him, we came to see him, and he should say something romantic.
So then gopis, they thought, oh, but Krishna is very rasic. And rasa is not expressed directly, it's expressed by dvani. So then gopis realize something. That he's saying that when we are in separation, then we see Krishna in our heart. But Krishna is also outside. But that Krishna outside and that Krishna inside is same.
Но также мы видим Кришну вовне. Но тот Кришна, который у нас внутри, и Кришна, который существует вовне, это один и тот же Кришна.
So that is prem tattva.
Это prema tattva.
Premanjana Churita Bhakti Vilochanena Sansat Santaksadeva Ridayeshu Vilokaya, who those who always seeing Krishna in the heart, even though Krishna is in Goloka Vrindavan, but they always see him in the heart. So he is inside but also outside. So this is Prem Tattva.
Те, кто всегда видит Кришну в своем сердце, несмотря на то, что Кришна может быть на голове Вриндавана, это тот же самый Кришна. Это Прем Тактва.
So Krishna told Uddhav, when you read my message to the gopis, read it three times.
И Кришна, когда отправлял суд Удава с посланием для гопи, он сказал им, прочитай это послание три раза.
So then gopis said, what else did Krishna say?
Гопи сказали, а что еще Кришна передал?
But instead of going to another message, Buddha repeated the same.
И вместо того, чтобы начать читать другое послание, Будда прочитал то же самое.
And hearing for the third time, gopis had another realization.
И в третий раз уже гопи получили другую реализацию.
Here, inside and outside, actually means on a deeper level, apakat lila and prakat lila.
На более глубоком уровне внутри и снаружи имеет в виду прокат лилу и апрокат лилу.
That those gopis who were in separation with Krishna, outside they were seeing Krishna's prakat lila, and inside what they thought was a sporty of Krishna was actually the apakat lila in the spiritual world. That's what they were seeing internally.
То есть, когда гопи были в разлуке с Кришной, и они видели спурди Кришны, на самом деле, это спурди – это проявление апракатливы, которое они видели
в спурди. So, Krishna said, «Бхавати нам, мадапанаха, о гопис, you already attained me. You're already with me».
Кришна сказал, «О гопи, ты уже со мной».
So, it's just a question of гопис авеш, where their absorption is.
Это просто вопрос о вашей погруженности гопи, где куда погружены это знание.
If the gopis in this prakat lila, absorption will go more inside, they'll say, actually I'm with Krishna eternally in the aprakat lila.
Если гопи находится в прокат лиле, и она погрузит знание вовнутрь, она осознает, что на самом деле я уже с Кришной.
And I am with him, and this separation lila is only one bhav within my life.
И на самом деле вот эта вот разлука, которую я чувствую, это просто такая лила разлуки внутри моей жизни.
And if they become absorbed in that bhav, then their abhiman will be in the prakat lila, and they'll think that the aprakat lila is one bhav in the prakat lila. If they'll be absorbed in their separation, then they'll instead of thinking they're with Krishna, they'll think that they're in this world and separated from him, and their bhav is that they're with him. So one perspective, I am here and this is my bhav, or in another avesh, I am here and that's my bhav. Understand?
Ну, то есть они поймут, что с одной стороны, я здесь, а вот это вот, например, разлука, это моя баба, и точно так же наоборот.
Understand?
Я там, и вот это вот моя
Don't
баба.
Don't worry, this is praying tattva.
Если вы не знаете, я не могу, но здесь это
You have to have praying to understand.
Вам нужно прямо, чтобы это понять.
So anyway, that verse, Yatama Hanti Bhutani, is about prayojan, the praying. The highest
one.
So if you follow the last verse, Etavani vajigyasya tadvajigyasya pana anvati rekabhan vyatsat savata savata, the last verse, means surrender to Guru and do sadhana continuously without interruption under guidance of Guru. Then gradually one can realize the previous verse, the prem tattva yatama hanti bhutani.
В четвертом стихе написано, что прежде всего вы должны принять убежище гуру и совершать бхакти следуя его наставлениям непрерывно. И тогда вы постепенно осознаете предыдущие стихи.
So these secrets of prem tattva have been elaborately described with the very pramana of these verses, Chatusloki Bhagavatam, Kurukshetra Prasanga, and the message of Krishna to Uddhava Sandesh by Srila Jiva Goswami. In the very end, last sandarbha, priti sandarbha. So it's very difficult to understand unless one has been through the tattva sandarbha and the Bhagavad sandarbha and Krishna's Paramatma Sandarbha, Krishna Sandarbha, Bhakti Sandarbha, and then Priti Sandarbha.
Очень сложно это понять, если вы не изучили сначала Тарба Сандарбху, другие Джива Сандарбху.
First Тарба Сандарбха, then Bhagavad Sandarbha, then Paramatma Sandarbha, then Krishna Sandarbha, then Bhakti Sandarbha, and last is Priti Sandarbha.
Bhakti Sandarbha, а затем Priti Sandarbha.
First four Сандарбхас are on only Sambandha Gyan. And then Bhakti Sandarbha is Abhideya and Priti Sandarbha Prayoja.
Затем Bhakti Sandarbha это Abhideya, а Priti Sandarbha это
Prayoja. Essence of all these Sandarbhas we're telling in our class, if you stay and listen for a long time, gradually you can catch it.
В наших классах уже рассказывают об этом содержании этих Сандарбх, и постепенно, если вы слушаете, вы сможете понять.
Гор Брахмананде.